is Friday. It's summer. So what are we waiting for? Let's get this party started.
And just because the weather is heating up doesn't mean you have to.
We've got some no heat, no cook entertaining ideas from food and lifestyle expert Alejandra Ramos.
Oh, hi.
How are you?
So excited.
We promised Robin a beverage or two.
Okay, yeah.
I know.
And I'm gonna drink over there.
So yeah.
Okay. Okay. Tell us what we have.
All right. So frosé all day. So this is rose watermelon frosé.
Nice.
So you puree watermelon with frozen watermelon, a little bit of Campari adds a little.
Can I try one?
I would love for you to try one.
Yes.
That one's super fun. It's really fresh and cool for a summer party.
And can you do this without the alcohol?
You can absolutely do it without alcohol.
Good.
You can
is it good? Oh my God, it's so good.
You can do like a non-alcoholic drink with that too. So you can enjoy.
Yes.
Then we've got two versions of my mermaid limeade. This one has some coconut rum in it, a little blue curacao. It's very tropical, very fun. Mm-hmm. And then because I wanted you to be able to party too.
Yeah, there you go.
We have our virgin mermaid limeade. And this one is made with coconut soda, which is like really like a coconut seltzer.
Oh, wow.
And then it's got limeade. So it's got all the same flavors and just a little bit friendly for everybody, the kids, everyone
That's
can
nice.
Enjoy.
I
That's
love
good.
That.
It's really good.
Okay. So now we're moving on to all of these dishes do not need any heat.
No oven, stove, no grill, no microwave, nothing.
That's great.
Yeah. All right, so here's what we do. This is the no-cook menu. We're going to start off with some no-cook couscous.
Which I didn't even think was possible.
I know. I didn't until recently, and now that I know about it, I'm obsessed.
It's changed your life.
So the thing about couscous is it's actually, some people think it's a grain, but it's actually a tiny pasta. It's made from semolina.
A pasta?
A tiny pasta.
Seriously?
So what's in the box is already, it's cooked and dried, so all you have to do is rehydrate it. What we're doing here is we're doing a dressing. So you add the dressing. This has some lemon juice in it. It's got a little bit of olive oil. We add some fun flavors. I've got some lemon. I've got some garlic, all sorts of good stuff. A lot of garlic.
It smells good already.
Yeah, it smells good, and then you can really have fun with all the other fixings. So over here, we've got some chickpeas. This makes it a great, like, a vegetarian entree.
Yes.
You want to help push all those in.
Too.
We've got all this onion, tomatoes,
cilantro,
some feta cheese. Actually, that's mint. Some feta cheese. So it's got kind of like a Greek salad sort of flavor, but honestly,
you can see.
See how it's starting to absorb that dressing? Pop this in the fridge for like an hour or two. It absorbs the dressing. You can even make it the day before, and it's ready. It's good
that's
to go.
Amazing.
This is what it looks
salad.
Like. How gorgeous is that?
Yes.
Have forks over here?
I know. We need some more tasting.
I know.
Well, these you can kind of grab and go. Okay. So these are chicken Caesar salad tacos.
May
yes, you
please
can.
Do. I love when people eat my food. So these, you get that rotisserie chicken from the grocery store, toss it with some greens, your favorite salad dressing. So easy. The taco shell makes it crunchy and perfect for a party. Not messy at all, right?
And this is a roast beef.
So these are my like little, it's like a twist on doing a little skirt steak sandwich. Mm-hmm. Instead, we're using roast beef. One of my absolute favorite kind of tips at the grocery store. I mean, it's steak, right? It is roasted beef, but you don't have to cook it.
I never eat roast beef.
Get it at the deli counter. I put a little chimichurri on top. That's a green herb sauce. So good.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Amazing. Now, this is great if you've got friends that are keto, low carb, they want something healthy. You take a cucumber.
This is cute.
So simple. You can use a melon ball or you can just use like a teaspoon. You scoop out the center and you make a little cup. There we go. Make a little cup with it.
Yes.
And then you can just put whatever you want inside.
Hummus.
We did some guacamole.
Oh,
we did some hummus.
Nice.
Salsa. Anything you want. It's so fun. So easy. Really cool.
Now let's move down to my section.
Yes.
This is my favorite part too. So DIY ice cream sandwich bar.
Oh my God, they're so cute.
How fun is this?
Kids would love this, right?
Kids would go crazy for this. Instead of cookies, you could do watermelon with sorbet.
Nice.
You could do like Rice Krispie treats with some kind of delicious thing inside. Banana bread.
Nice.
I mean, just raid the pantry, raid the grocery store, put everything out, let everybody have fun with it.
I'm gonna try these watermelons.
Oh my God, please do. And then you can have fun toppings. So I love these like that little Krispie cereal.
All of this.
I know.
I
would love for you to just take this and
thank you. I'm going to take this for the world. All right. Thank you so much, Alejandra, for these ideas and recipes. Head to today.com/food.
We are getting you ready for summer, and what better way to celebrate warmer weather than a backyard party? Today, contributor Elizabeth Highschool's here. She has some quick and easy ideas to help us entertain. No stress, no mess. Just yum.
That's it. You know, the thing is about summer entertaining that makes it so easy and fun is that, you know, you don't have to do it inside.
You're going to go outside. Mother Nature's already decorated everything for you. You don't have to worry about dust bunnies under your couch.
I like a paper plate, too.
Yes,
can we just say amen to a paper plate?
We've got amazing paper plates. So we're going to start with burgers. And these aren't just your average burgers. Honey, we are going to stuff these with pimento cheese.
I know.
Two of my favorite things in the entire world.
By the way, you're speaking the Southern Jennifer.
I know, I know. Please look at them. They're so excited. Okay, I'm sorry. Yeah, go ahead and give them
pimento. They want the pimento.
And the pickles.
She wants the pickles.
Don't forget the pickles.
One of the best days of my life.
Other than the children.
So now the thing you need to remember is that you don't want to overstuff this. I mean, you want to because we love it so much, but if you do too much, just going to ooh and goo everywhere.
It's ground beef.
Yes.
Okay,
I guess I should have started there.
Well,
okay,
I got
excited about the pimento cheese. So it's onions, it's ketchup, it's a little bit of egg to help bind it, salt and pepper.
Okay.
We're going to add that in here. So you can go ahead and start that. Why don't you do that?
I'll do that.
And I'm getting to my part that I'm so excited about.
Okay, me too.
And then we're going to take our other patty, we're going to put it on top. Now, you just want to press and seal. Press and seal.
Okay.
Make sure that you get that really, really sealed because otherwise, when we get over here to this pan, it's going to turn into a mess.
So you used a melon scooper, not an ice cream scooper. A melon scooper is the right amount of cheese.
It really is. It really is.
All right.
Okay. Now, we want to make sure we got to get this pan as hot as the hinges of hell. I mean, it has got to be so damn hot.
That's hot.
Because otherwise, it's just, it is not going to get that beautiful crust.
All right.
Let it sit.
Got it. Check.
Let it sit.
Yes.
Don't start bothering it with this spatula. Leave it alone. I always see people in there. Scrape
it. Yeah, I like to do a nice press down.
No, you don't. No, you press down. You lose all the juices. The juices stay in.
Okay.
So now we have our gorgeous burger.
Stop doing that.
Yes.
Okay.
We're going to build this burger.
But wait, the hot pan, isn't it going to get burned on the outside?
No.
How do we make sure it cooks?
No. You want that caramelized crust. I mean, that's what the burger, that's the best part of it.
Okay.
So it's perfectly fine. We're going to go about 7 minutes on each side. That'll be done and ready to go.
Got it.
Now, we're just going to add bacon. We've got some bread and butter pickles. Mm. You don't need to go mucking this up with a bunch of stuff.
What about sauce?
A
dry bun?
I mean, if you want that, you can have it. A little bit of mayonnaise is fine. A little bit of ketchup. Mm-hmm. But you've got all that good pimento inside. You don't need to.
Okay, wait. Let's get a verdict from the taste tester.
You could put a little more pimento on top.
You could put pimento on top.
There's never enough pimento.
Absolutely.
Right?
Now, this is our cornbread salad. I mean, I'm telling you, it will make potato salad look like a fool. It is the finest thing. And I know it sounds strange.
It looks so pretty.
But kind of think croutons. Think cornbread croutons is where I'm going with this. And then you layer up all the good stuff. You've got cheese. You've got bacon. You've got ranch dressing.
Yes.
And honey, there ain't anything better.
Say amen.
I mean, seriously, we've got a little bit of fresh corn. Layer. And then let it sit. Let it all that goodness soak in.
Was there a trick to making it look so pretty and getting a layer like that?
Well, no. I mean, it's super simple. You can start with your cornbread, and then you add all of your other things, and then continue to layer it up, and it'll be that pretty.
All right.
Now we're getting to my favorite part, and that's a cocktail.
Yeah.
Woo! So we've got some watermelon mojitos.
Mm-hmm.
But look what we're going to do. So you have your watermelon. We need to, we got to cut it out anyway. So why don't we just save it? I mean, let's leave this. We're going to pull this,
and
then we're going to make this fabulous little cooler. Is that not adorable?
Yeah, we'll show that in a minute.
And you can even get a bigger watermelon if you want. We're going to keep, you want to keep scooping?
Sure.
Okay, we'll let you scoop for just a second.
Sure.
We do is we do a simple syrup with sugar, mint, and water. We're going to cook that down, let it cool.
What do you mean cook?
We're going to boil.
Like put it,
we're
going to heat this up?
Yeah. Oh. No, I'm sorry. We're going to make a simple syrup first when we're making the drink. I'm going to go back to talking about the drink.
Okay.
So we have our water, we have our sugar, and a little bit of mint.
Mm-hmm.
Let that, cook it, let it melt, and then we're going to cool it.
Okay.
And then we add that to our frozen watermelon chunks.
Mm-hmm.
Once we take this out of here, we want to put this in the freezer, let it freeze, and then we're going to put it all in the blender and blend it up. So it's a frozen cocktail. We'll top it with a little bit of club soda.
Mm-hmm.
Here is our absolutely beautiful watermelon.
This is so cute. So you just scooped it out and made an ice bucket.
Exactly. And now the thing is, though, is that you want, I love this. This is it's a gift to bring to your hostess.
Oh.
You want to know how to be a good guest so that you can invite it back. I mean, if you were raised right, you know to bring something.
Of course.
Yes.
And so this is one of my favorites. It's paper plates, adorable paper plates. And then the little tag says, oh, let me do the dishes. So you bring that. You've got the paper plates. Isn't
that
adorable?
Funny.
And there are lots of really fun ones. Like, look at the ones they've got. So they've got these wonderful bamboo plates.
Love bamboo.
You can throw it away.
Yep.
Nobody's going to be in the kitchen cussing because they were left to do all the dishes.
But I didn't even know you were doing this paper plates thing. And that's the first thing I thought of. If you're outside, paper plates.
You've got to.
Yes.
I mean, it really does make it so much more simple. And that's what summer's about. Summer is easy, laid back, and fun.
Did y'all taste that drink?
Yes.
So even the mocktail is good. I don't know how you did
good.
It.
Thank you. Recipes at today.com/food.
Hey, thanks for watching our YouTube channel. Find your favorite recipes, celebrity interviews, uplifting stories, shop our favorite deals, and so much more with the Today app. Download it now.